beaten and still get up to try for what. And those won't stop the bleeding. Forgive us today our daily bread and pour no pain upon our heads. Across my heart and fear to die. I may have stooped, but I don't lie. And I miss you. It's the metal victories that reignite your engines, but poison drains a few and far between, and all that's left is tension. Just to win once a god's magic, there's nothing like top feeling. But what a sense must sink again, and I am no exception. Forgive us today our daily bread and pour no pain upon our heads. Across my heart and fear to die. I may have stooped, but I don't lie. And I miss you.
This tastes fishy.
Fishy?
Yeah, fishy.
Fishy how? Fishy good or fishy bad?
You know, fishy. I guess that's bad if it's supposed to be a chicken strip.
Actually, it's a fish stick.
Oh, in that case, I guess it's the good kind of fishy.
Holy crap, a talking dog.
You have the sweetest laugh. Did you know that?
Thank you.
Now, where did you tell me you were from again?
Ohio.
Oh, what part?
Coshocton.
I've been to Coshocton. I went to the Apple Butter Festival.
Really?
Oh, splendid town.
It's such
splendid.
A quaint little town.
Yes. Anyone hurl on you yet? You know, how desperate are these people? They'll eat this shit for a lousy $50. Jesus, Dan, no wonder you're not getting any. Check that out. What a waste. Why do women do that to themselves?
I wonder if she's coming back after the baby.
I hope not.
What do you mean, man? I like her.
That bitch? Taking credit for all our work? Dude, she's sleeping with the old man. Wouldn't surprise me if that was his. Tracy, I love your shoes. Are they designer?
Wilson, I'm gonna need your last two Bronson marketing studies on my desk by the end of the day. I assume you're almost done.
No, of course. So how far along are you? 8 months? You must be excited. You look about ready to pop.
Dan, conference room. Now.
I've been watching you.
Okay.
I think you have potential, Dan. But you're scared to use it. What scares you, Dan? Does this scare you?
How about this?
Dan!
What are you scared of? Why are you holding back?
I don't think I'm holding back.
Do you want to get somewhere in this world, Dan?
What do you mean?
Something big is coming up with Bronson. Of course, they offered me the project, but I told Chuck no. Shit, you should have seen his face when I told him. I was taking my maternity leave early, and that was it. But he's got a soft spot for me, so I told him to give it to you.
Really? Jeez, Tracy, thanks. I didn't know that you cared.
I don't. I do a little. Look, you're the only guy here who hasn't tried to stab me in the back or check out my ass every time I turn around. That has to count for something. Dan, pay attention. Here's what you need to do.
So she tells me everything I need to know to nail this promotion. Yeah, maybe I'll get a big raise. No, this is good. I mean, maybe my career's finally going somewhere. Of course I'm happy, Mom. Why do you... Look, I gotta go. I got a lot of work to do. Yeah, I know. No, I don't know the product yet, but that's why I've gotta work. Okay, yeah, I love you too. Okay, bye.
September 25th, 1968, that Leonid Brezhnev made an unscheduled stop in Seattle, Washington. While there, he quietly met with Washington Senator Scoop Jackson and trade representatives to settle a thorny international fishing dispute.
Brothers, sisters, saints and sinners, crimes and misdemeanors, we are all under a higher power. See, there are some people out there, people smarter than me.
Oh, God.
Love to read books.
Oh, you know, God.
I enjoy reading the fine print in the good book as much as the next person, but these are people. People of higher education. People who want to take the
word,
break it down. Figures, components, and analyze.
How many of you have thought, I just don't have time to make a home-cooked meal after a long day at work? Well, what if I told you, you could have that home-cooked meal and in just 10 minutes? That's right. And not just any meal, but a meal of delicious, succulent, fresh fish sticks. But how is that possible? Fish sticks are so time-consuming and complicated, right? Well, not anymore. Because through the miracle of modern technology and our friends who brought us the Bronson Funbrella, it's my pleasure to present to you the Bronson Staccato Fish Stick Maker. That's right, it's fresh, it's fish.
How could I not know about new Bronson products?
So in just a few easy steps, I'm gonna show you how you can turn the tasteless raw materials that make up fresh fish into a delicious, succulent fish stick dinner. Let's begin, shall we? We start off by removing the top on our fish blender, which we call the flender. Now, in the flender, we can put any fish that we want. It could be an Alaskan rainbow snapper, or a North African mackerel. As long as that fish has a fin and a tail, the staccato has no problem with it. Into the flender. Now I'm going to activate the fish blending unit, which we call the flender unit, and here we go. Just one step closer to fresh fish sticks. So now, our next step is to add one of our many delicious seasoning packets. My favorite is Dutch Crunch. Notice the drainage of the flender as the fish stick batter oozes onto the fresh fish grill, or the frill. Now all you have to do is activate the cook button, and in just 5 minutes, you've got delicious fish sticks.
Psst. Daniel. Daniel Roy Anderson.
What?
A little focus.
Are you talking to me?
You know, Daniel, I've known you your entire life now. Actually, I can take full credit for your creation, with a little help from your mom and dad, of course.
What's going on?
Daniel. Concentrate. You've always been a little loopy, but I guess that's my fault too. Look, it's over. It's done. I thought that this whole freedom of choice thing was a solid idea at the time, but in hindsight, I am not so sure. I mean, maybe I should have been a little more stringent. Look at where your species is going, son. Nobody's paying attention, yourself included. A path has been set, and the time is almost near. Daniel, you're a decent guy, better than most. So I'm gonna give you one final opportunity. Go find your son.
Her? Find who? Her?
Your soulmate. It's all you've ever wanted. What everyone wants, really, when you strip it down to basics. But you've just been living in denial. So no more refutation. The world blows up tomorrow.
Wait, what? What the hell?
Hey, wrong place, and watch the language.
Now, how much would you pay for this wonderful time-saving unit? Don't answer yet, because if you order within the next 2 minutes, you'll get a second staccato fish stick maker for free. That's right.
What the hell are you doing?
Wilson.
Hey, I heard you're meeting with Chuck. What did you tell that bitch?
Nothing. Who? What bitch?
Tracy, Dan. Come on. What are you doing meeting with Chuck?
I'm meeting with a client.
It's Bronson, isn't it? Oh, we are partnering up on this. Come on. We came in together. You need me. We're a good fit. No, scratch that. We are a great fit.
Is he here yet?
Don't be a bitch, Dan.
Which one of you is Anderson?
I am, sir.
Tracy says you're the best of what's left.
Yes, sir.
You better be. Let's do this. You need a haircut. And a decent tie.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you don't know the answer, don't bullshit, but don't just sit there with your thumb up your ass either. Got it?
So, just small talk?
No. You know the answer.
I do?
You better, or you're fired. Chuck!
Buck!
You ready for a little action?
I'll blow you if you blow me.
Away. You got it. Hey, let me introduce you to my latest whiz kid. Dan?
Anderson, sir. Dan Anderson.
You got that one calling you a sir. What'd you do, start matching their 401ks? You've all signed your non-disclosures, and I know where your mothers live. Prepare yourselves to be blown away. Wesson! Thank you, Wesson. Gentlemen, may I present the TX ALL138FRSTK.
The fish stick maker.
What did you say?
Fresh fish. Fresh.
Yes?
You put the fish in the blender, drain it, and out comes fresh fish sticks in 10 minutes.
5 minutes.
Last night, the infomercial. I saw the little fish stick guy.
Who are you? Who are you working for?
You?
No one outside the lab has seen this. My engineers have been working on this
we
for...
We are in the business of anticipating our clients' needs. Yeah, we've been in a slump, but we are coming back with a holy vengeance. Dan, explain to him how we're gonna market this fish stick maker into every American household.
Priorities, Dan. The end is nigh, and you have not started looking for the one.
Why are you doing this to me?
I'm a romantic.
Why are you ending the world?
Because I'm God.
This can't be real.
Oh, this is real, all right, O ye of little faith.
Hell of a show! Hell of a show, Dan! You remind me of the old man in his prime.
Give me a few minutes to talk to the kid alone, Buck. And then we'll break open that bottle of scotch I won from you.
Stole from me, it's more like it, you son of a bitch.
Are the rumors true?
Rumors?
That you nailed it.
Are they saying that? Wow, that's cool. No, wait, Wilson. I have no idea what just happened in there. It was like...
an out-of-body experience?
Yeah.
Lo and behold, brother Dan, we are going to be running this joint in no time.
You're not really listening to me. This isn't about our job.
You know, that whole Tracy thing, I had it all wrong. You were playing her, weren't you? Coming on like a complete sap, and then wham, bam. You are a freaking rock star.
Wilson, just listen to me for a second, okay? Do you believe in God?
Is this a trick question? Yeah, maybe.
Well, what if I told you that I had a sign? I mean, not even a sign. I was told explicitly that the world was going to end tomorrow. Would you believe in God? I mean, would you believe in me?
This is what I'm talking about. You are a madman. This is some kind of motivational play. You're testing me. I get it. Give me some more.
No, you don't get it. We're wasting our lives. I'm wasting my life.
Can I ask you one important question?
Yeah.
Is it true you can hire a secretary? Because that Carol chick, I don't think she's that into school, and she might appreciate a full-time gig, you know? Really appreciate it.
I quit.
I'll tell the Chucky you're taking lunch. We're gonna celebrate, right? Give me a call in my cell when you get there, and we'll hook up.
I quit?
Yeah, right. Give me a call, Dan. You and me, buddy. See you soon. Bye.
Yeah, yeah. Do I know you?
I buy flowers for my mom sometimes.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, you look familiar.
Dan. My name's Dan. There's a girl that works here. She's short, brown hair, has glasses. I need to talk to her. I need to see her right away. About a floral arrangement. She does this great thing with baby's breath.
Carrie's not here.
Carrie,
I can help you.
Does Carrie work today?
I can help you if you're in a hurry.
Oh, it's not that you could help me. It's that... well, Carrie and I had this amazing conversation about 18th century literature, and she had this awesome... Do you know if she has a boyfriend?
Excuse me?
Never mind.
Are you a stalker?
No.
Hey, she comes in at 4. She has a boyfriend, but I don't think they're serious. By the way, you really suck at this. I mean, if you're coming back at 4, you need to chill out or she's gonna call the cops.
I don't. Okay, I don't do this. That's my problem.
Hey, just lighten up.
Okay. 4?
4. But to tell you the truth, she's way out of your league. No, seriously, but you do look like a great candidate for online dating. I mean, there are a lot of desperate women out there.
I don't have time for that.
Yeah, I don't have it. Broadband either. Hey, but you should check out theperfectcatch.net. I mean, you don't even have to submit a photo. I think that might work for you.
Maybe I'll give that a try.
Hey, we only go around once, right?
I'm still coming back at 4.
Hey, great. Hey, you might want to buy something next time.
Welcome to theperfectcatch.net. Do see personality profile. Enter your info. I am a woman seeking a man, man seeking a woman. I am... My personality is bubbly, saucy, perky, morose, all fabulous, no personality. Okay. I would describe my body type as lithe, athletic, scrumptious, ample, bootylicious. Alright. My hobbies include fishing, tennis, golf, spelunking, jogging, reading, watching TV, and water sports. Good. My annual income is... I am a religious person. Please describe a childhood memory. Oh my gosh, look at all these questions. I best express myself through watercolor. I drink alcohol all the time. For me, commitment relationship is important. Which of the following is most important material possessions? Seven. Dan Anderson. Dan Anderson. Ugh. Dan Anderson. Operator. 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 Yes, yes, hi. Yes, I recently filled out a survey on your online website for perfectcatch.net. Perfect catch. Yeah. Yes, Dan Anderson. Mm-hmm. When did I fill the survey out? Today. 10 minutes ago. Yeah. I know it takes a long time. I am a patient person, usually. Actually, it's a fault, really. Well, what if I don't have a week? No, I'm not sick. I understand. Yes, I understand that. Okay, Judith, happy fishing to you, too.
Ready for another night of unseasonal temperatures and a rough. We have a low front coming.
Hey. Are you there?
Now that's going to mix with a.
If you're there, can you hear me?
Low atmospheric.
How do I know this isn't some kind of aneurysm or. I don't know, a flashback maybe? I'm not sure I appreciate being singled out. Maybe I need a kick in the ass, but the world ending? Come on.
Yes?
Daniel Anderson?
Yes?
Shelley Williamson, Executive Marketing VP for the PerfectCatch.net. You filled out a personality profile in the last half hour?
Oh, yes. Sorry I called in. You have no idea what kind of day I've had. Did I do something
Daniel,
wrong?
Daniel, something extraordinary has happened. I need to meet you right away.
When you say extraordinary, does that have anything to do with fish sticks?
Charming. You're very funny. From what I see, we are meant to be together.
Oh, okay. Okay, that's more like it.
Fabulous. You don't even know me, but you seized the moment. Our records show that you called in to follow up immediately. A man who wants results, but doesn't have time to wait for them. This is going to work out just fine. This is where you'll meet me. The Bistro 330 at 1130. Put it in your BlackBerry if you want to.
Got it.
I hate tardiness. Bye, Daniel.
Yes. I'm gonna give you a choice.
I like chicken dishes.
No, not about the food. I'm gonna give you a choice about what kind of date you're gonna have.
Dan. You picked a day, I'm making choices.
Joaquin.
Joaquin. Whether or not they're the right choices remains to be seen.
Ow! What the hell was that for?
You said hell.
Oh yeah, I said hell, that hurt.
Just checking to see if you're real.
Boo. I'm real. Listen, here's your choice. I can be your generic, fill the water, take the order, smile politely, waiter. I'm good with that, okay? Or I can be the blind date master.
Are you still gonna fill the waters? Because I get really thirsty.
Lesson number one. Multiple bathroom trips express disinterest to a lady. You need to go to the can right now and then dehydrate yourself during the meal.
I don't have to go.
I am the blind date master. You need to go.
I should go. I should go. I have no idea what I'm doing.
Lesson number two. Don't be so hard on yourself, boo. I mean, like the water. Think before you cut yourself down. A little can be charming, but too much and you're screaming baggage alert.
Thanks. Are you an actor?
I told you I'm a waiter. There's no shame in that.
You just seem a little unique.
Funny. My dad used to say that. Fate must have brought you here, Dan. This ain't even my shift. There's the waltz. I'll be right back with your order, sir.
What did you say about fate?
Well, they say you can't put a price on happiness, but I think we just proved them wrong, didn't we? Remember to let everyone know that if they mention your tale of bliss, they'll get a 10% discount. Ciao, Mr. Sharpio, and thank you for your prompt payment.
Shelly.
Daniel, I'm Shelly. Two L's, two E's. This is very exciting. Turn around, please. Exactly what I was thinking. What's your BMI?
BMI?
Body mass index? Never mind. 5'9"?
My height of 5'9½.
Between 145 and 150?
Close enough.
We're all a work in progress, aren't we? You're certainly not obese, but you are considered overweight. That does have a significant impact on your mental health as well. And honestly, how much time do we have? On this planet, I mean.
Wow, that's my thoughts exactly.
Considering the fact that you work out 5 times a week, this is a little odd. What does your trainer have you doing?
Oh, pilates, spinning, weightlifting.
I have a fabulous trainer you should call. We should start working out together. Partners can motivate each other to higher levels. I apologize in advance, but I'm still on the clock, so I may need to conduct a little business during our date. You don't mind, do you?
No, do what you need to do.
Fabulous. I know this is the most important meeting of our lives, but you of all people would understand. By the way, congratulations on your recent promotion. I'm excited for you.
Thanks. That means a lot to me. I mean,
not the job part, that this meeting is so important. I feel the same way.
Wonderful. This could be the beginning of a whole new stage of our lives and my career. Can you imagine the potential of the VP of marketing finding her perfect match at Perfect Catch?
How does this work exactly? I haven't had many blind dates.
Oh, this is not a blind date. No, I hate that term. Don't you understand? I know you. I know more about you than most of your friends do.
Well, that's not hard. I don't have...
Would you like to hear the specials?
Oh, I called ahead and already know the specials, so you don't have to bother. Thank you very much.
And how about the gentleman? Did he call too?
I'd like to hear.
We're not interested right now. We're trying to have a private moment here. Don't have a lot of time.
Okay, well, let me know when you need me. Questions? Help?
Got it.
Thanks. We'll let you know.
He's not the usual lunch waiter. Trust me, Janine is much less intrusive.
You really seem to know your stuff. How long have you been in the love business?
Love? Oh, that's so cute, Daniel. You sound just like one of my clients. At first, even the most professional, no-nonsense individuals are completely brainwashed with a lifetime of fairy tale indoctrination. Love. Did you know love-based marriage is essentially a modern concept? Partnerships based on love are alien to the majority of human history. Love gets in the way of a healthy, strong partnership, and we have proven it time and time again. It's my job to break them of the fantasy, the illusion of love.
That seems a little extreme.
Let me finish, please. So, if it's not about love, then what is it about? Well, the truth is in the numbers. It's in the Blissitron program. The Blissitron, the patented software behind the perfectcatch.net. You must have missed the link on our homepage. I need to talk to our web designers about that. Anyway, Daniel, what's really exciting is that you, out of the millions of men in our database, were selected by the Blissitron to be my match.
Me?
Yes. I realize that people might embellish the details when they're filling out the surveys. That is why I have asked the programmers, the product managers, and the relationship analysts to set my Blissitron match filters extremely high, which may be why I haven't dated anyone in over a year. But 37 minutes ago, your name popped up. It was a miracle.
A miracle?
Of modern technology. I mean, who wants to waste their time on elaborate rituals of courtship? Well, I'm willing to do a little of that for your sake, since this isn't your area of expertise.
Thank God I didn't waste my $350.
You're damn lucky for $350.
This is a lot to take in, but it's kind of the way my day is going, so I'm willing to give it a shot. Us. And hey, if this is what you do, and some higher power is telling me, us, that we're meant to be together, then... let's give it a go.
I knew you would say that.
Really? How?
The Blissitron.
Shelly, let's say that you were fired.
I would never be fired, never.
Okay, hypothetically, you have one day to live.
I don't deal in hypotheticals, Daniel.
Let's say it wasn't hypothetical, and the world was ending.
Okay, well, flexibility is important. I don't usually like these kind of games, but since this isn't all about me and I must have missed something in your chart, I'll be a good sport and I'll play along. So, the world is ending. Fine.
What would you do?
I call my clients.
You call your clients?
Fine, why don't you tell me what I should be doing?
Well, I'm sorry, but why would you be thinking about work at a time like this?
Daniel, my work is my life.
It doesn't make any sense. I mean, what about friends and family?
Exactly! Helping someone find their life partner is a 24/7 profession. But my work has its perks. I'm here with you. So are we finished now? Did I win something?
Shelly, are you a religious person?
Oh, here we go again. So, how is the world ending?
Hmm? I can't answer that.
Ice Age, Black Hole, Invaders from Mars.
Armageddon.
Oh, Daniel. Do you accept Jesus Christ as your personal savior?
I don't want to answer that right now.
Why not?
I don't want to lock myself into anything. Shelly, I'm sorry.
Daniel, did you fill out the questions on the forums truthfully? Because those geeks claim they compensate for that, but I've always wondered.
I answered them quickly, very quickly, but for the most part, yes.
Then we're a match.
Maybe we're expecting too much.
Daniel, I believe that the choices I've made in my life had led me to this place, and that is all I believe. Now, according to the Blissitron, you believe that as well. The world is not ending tomorrow, but if it did, I would call my clients, tell them I'm taking the day off to find my perfect catch, and encourage them to use our technology to do the same. But forget all that. My entire career experience up to this point has led me to believe that you are my perfect catch. The numbers don't lie.
I have to go to the bathroom. Thank God you're here. I know you said not to go to the bathroom, but I didn't know what else to do. I don't think she's Mrs. Wright.
Relax. Breathe. Breathe deep.
Joaquin, I'm running out of time. I'm pretty certain that Shelley isn't the one, but I'm just not sure. What do I do?
Dan, I told you I'd help you get the lady, not ditch the lady. Oh. Ultimately, it's not my choice. It's yours. Okay. Okay. Giddy up, cowboy.
I have to take this to go, but do not tip our waiter. He's an embarrassment to his profession. I had to get this box myself.
You're leaving?
I have a compatibility emergency I need to take care of immediately. I called a cab for you. I will meet you for dinner tonight at Carlucci's in North Beach, okay? Be there at 7:30. Get us a table. I'll be there at 8. We have a lot of work to do, Daniel. This first encounter was very confusing. I say we start over tonight.
Shelley, I think you're a wonderful woman.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to make this easy. Look, I've had a life-changing
experience, blah, blah, blah. Look, let's just cut to the chase, okay? If you were anyone else, I would tell you to fuck off. Because no one breaks up with me, I break up with them. Your numbers
are
so...
Shelley, what are you doing? You don't have to do this. We don't know each other. Why are you getting worked up?
I'm not getting worked up. Who's getting worked up? We don't have to know each other because we are perfect for each other. Damn it. I'm letting my emotions get in the way. Shelley, what are you doing? Why can't you just accept the fact that it is all about the interests, the tests, the answers? These are tangible results. But love? Come on, Daniel.
I prefer Dan.
Show a little self-control like I'm doing. We can work this out. This is meant to be. It is so simple. Don't make it complicated.
I'm sorry.
Sit down, Daniel.
I'm controlling myself.
Daniel, sit down. You don't walk out on me. I walk out on you.
You're not going to listen to her about that tip, are you?
So, Mr. Blind Date.
Blind Date Master.
What works for guys in a pinch?
Just follow your eyes.
Shelley Williamson. Yes, Miss Woodland, thank you for returning my call. No, he's a perfect fit for you. What you need to do is get past your feelings for your ex. We've talked about this. Miss Woodland. Miss Woodland, don't cry. Don't let him have the satisfaction. It's not worth it, Evelyn.
I love those shoes. Are they designer?
Excuse me?
Your shoes. I really like their style.
Yours could use a little work.
Well, what's not working for you?
If you're gonna ask me out, do it. Don't shuffle about it.
Okay, well, can I buy you a drink?
Dale, this will not do.
Ask your girlfriend.
I refuse to accept this. Are you trying to embarrass me professionally? Did someone coach you?
Look, I don't have time for this, Shelley.
Why would you pay $350, go to all the trouble to fill out the forms, and not even give the results a chance?
I did give it a chance, and I wasted $350. Now go away.
You just missed your perfect catch. I'm just thankful that I responded, not one of our clients. Trust me, heads will roll for letting an asshole like you in our system. Can't believe I wasted my time with you.
Speaking of time...
No, wait.
I will not wait. I've done enough.
Not you.
Oh, God, are you talking to that skank?
Excuse me?
Don't even. I know Krav Maga.
Is everything okay here?
Look, Shelley, this is ridiculous. You're overreacting.
I don't know this woman. I don't know you.
You're way out of your league, bitch. And you. If you have a psycho like that after you, that's a trick. What?
That's one of my glasses. What are you doing? That comes out of my pay.
I have no idea how that got there. She did it. Tell him, Daniel. Tell him that tramp put the glass in my purse.
It's Dan. It's Dan. Why can't you get that through your head?
What are you doing? Don't you think you can touch me there? I will sue this place into oblivion.
Lady, I did not touch you anywhere. Don't flatter yourself.
Oh, I am speaking to your manager. You are so fired.
Oh, no. Well, my uncle, the manager, is right this way. Follow me, ma'am. Let's talk about martini glass.
What do you think you're doing?
Okay, that's enough. I think we should all go and work this out. Now would be a bad time to start believing in karma.
Anderson. I don't see an Anderson. Are you sure you're here on the right day?
I just want to get in there and meet someone.
That's the plan, isn't it? Oh, you didn't sign up, did you?
I'm a little confused.
Dine and date. I'm Tammy, today's host. Meeting many while noshing? I could tell you a little bit about our program if you want. It's F-U-N fun.
I was supposed to meet someone here. They didn't tell me I needed a reservation. This is a little embarrassing.
No. There's no reason to be embarrassed. This is a blast. It's low pressure, and you get to meet a lot of really, really great people in a short amount of time. I met my husband here. You can meet someone, too.
I'm gonna be honest with you. I recently had a bad experience with theperfectcatch.net.
Bad?
Really, really bad.
Oh, that's awful. I've heard some really bad things about Perfect Catch. I'm sorry. I don't mean to scare you off. This is completely different.
Really? I don't know.
Look, if you've had a bad experience, I think you should just get right back on that horse, mix it up, and have a great time. I'll tell you what. A spot just opened up, and I really shouldn't be doing this, but I'll let you in for free.
Must be my lucky day.
All right, everybody! Dine and date!
I hate the food at these things, don't you? What is that supposed to be, anyway? You'd think they'd know that most of us are here to meet someone. We can't afford to eat cheese. Not unless some of these girls get more bathroom breaks so they can do what we all know they have to. Do you actually like those?
I haven't had a chance to try.
Are you gonna eat that?
Help yourself.
Help myself? That's exactly what my therapist told me. So I like to fill my room with candles and just chant for hours. I think I've been a really good example for my roommates because they finally got off the couch. It's almost like I'm living by myself. TV's no good for you anyway. It's so much better to be active.
Sounds healthy.
It is. I get up every morning and run 10 miles. I'm a professional fitness competitor, and I really don't have too much time for a man in my life. But I thought this was quick, and it is on the way to the gym.
The gym?
Jim. He likes to watch.
Change! Take a lap! Change! Rotate! Change!
What are you, some kind of stalker? What are you doing here?
What? No. I wasn't following you. Okay, I was following you, but that whole thing at the restaurant, that...
Oh, defending your girlfriend. Knight in shining armor. What are you gonna do, smite me with your sword?
She's not my girlfriend. I don't have a girlfriend.
This is speed dating, so no time for long stories. Are you here to bust me or what? You look like a cop. Are you a narc because you dress like one?
I don't know what to say to that.
I don't like cops. They're always putting me in handcuffs.
For what?
Find a pair of handcuffs and, I'll let you know.
Do-si-do!
Well?
Well, what?
Are you hanging out here? Or are you gonna come back to my place?
Lead the way.
Sorry, sweetie. This one's taken. Boy, how is that?
Well, it's not what I imagined.
Most people don't have much of an imagination now, do they? Don't disappoint me like all the others.
Do you do this often?
Don't get judgmental. You're lucky I'm even giving you the time of day after that scene with your girlfriend.
What are you doing?
Just trying to get a better idea of who you are. Before we, you know.
Well, can't we talk about this?
Oh, I'm surprised at you. The moment you saw me at the restaurant, we've been talking, and I know what's been on your mind. And it isn't your girlfriend, but that's pretty typical, isn't it?
I don't have a girlfriend. It was a first date. It wasn't even really a date.
I don't know. Her eyes were pretty fiery for a first date.
It was a first date, I swear it.
Okay, okay. I'm on your side. No need to get all worked up.
What did you mean by typical?
I see scenes like that play out all the time. Girls like Miss Prissy in there really fucking piss me off, and trust me. They're little girls for acting like that, not women.
Shelly's not my type, but that's a little harsh, don't you think?
What is your type, Dan? You're obviously such a macho stud that you can pick up any girl you want.
That is so not true.
What if the one for you, the woman who could fill your life with everything you could possibly need to make you happy, what if that woman doesn't fit into your narrow little type? What then, Dan? Sorry. Sometimes I start spouting off a little bit and I have no idea what I just said. At least no one got hurt this time, did they?
Did you just go into some type of trance just now? What's the last thing you remember? Did you hear a voice?
Oh, yeah!
No, last night, I went into a trance and I think I saw God.
You have drugs and you're not sharing?
No, it wasn't drugs. I had a vision during a presentation at work. And then another one the night before.
Boring.
It told me that the world was gonna end tomorrow and that I had one day to find my soulmate.
So you've suffered a complete breakdown. Anything else I should know about?
I need to talk to you about Shelly and what happened last night.
You slept with her and now she's some girl you met.
No, you've got it all wrong.
Dan, do you want to know what I was thinking about when I took your picture?
I don't know. That you were interested in me?
I was thinking about that girl you hurt.
You put the glass in her purse.
Yeah, so I stuck a glass in her purse. You look in her eyes, she didn't care too much for me, not really. Did you bother to do that, look into her eyes?
We just met. I mean, I thought there was a connection between us. I had to follow you.
Because the world is ending?
Men will say anything to get laid.
Did you bother to look into her eyes?
I looked at her.
You're not listening to me. Why don't men ever listen?
No, you're right. I didn't. She was pretty intense.
No, Dan. I'm intense. She was just protecting herself.
From what?
Not what.
No. That's bullshit. I wasn't a threat to her. I was. She had some messed up ideas.
Oh yeah, but the world ending tomorrow is pretty fucking mainstream.
We had just met. Even if we argued, that's not a bad thing. I don't think she even thought enough of me to question herself. She thought love could be all graphed and charted and ran through some computer program.
That is fucked up.
See? That's not who I am. That's not like me.
No, you're a true believer, aren't you? Getting by on faith.
I honestly don't know what I'm getting by on.
Lucky I found you in time to rescue you.
That's honestly what I thought.
If it was luck, maybe it was a higher power. Hold on, I'm almost done.
You know, I don't even know your name.
Do you think that it contains the essence that is you?
Sure.
Enough with the plate, then.
I have been serious. I am serious.
Let's move over to the window. I'd like to see what I'm doing.
Trust someone.
And stay there and don't move.
What are you doing?
Just trying to get to the truth.
I don't know about this. I'm not really into the bondage thing. I think it'd be best if you let me go. Let me go or I'll start screaming.
Go ahead. We're in the middle of nowhere. And listening to desperate mail calls turns me on. For you, big boy. Special delivery from Shelly and all the other women you fucked over in the past.
What women? I don't even date.
Hey, Amy, it's me. When you get off work, I got someone here who wants to meet you.
He's a true believer.
Peace out.
Voila. Hey there, Rip Van Wrinkled.
What's going on? Where's...
My roommate, Betsy? She's not here right now. I thought we should be alone. Hold on. I want to get the mood right. Told me all about you. I made salmon.
Great. I guess that means you won't be eating me then?
Excellent. Okay. It's not funny. okay. Sorry.
What's going on here?
You're sort of a wild child. Betsy was right.
Oh, my head is killing me. Did she drug me? Who are you?
Okay. Can I start over? Yeah.
Wait, where are you going? I need to get out of here right now. Don't leave me.
Shh. Let me work on this. Hi, honey. I didn't expect you home so early. I fixed you a drink.
Who are you?
Amy.
Amy. Could you please untie me so I don't have to call the police? I don't want to have to do that.
Okay, Betsy and the police. Not until I hear the safety word. And until then, young man, you are going to have to be spoon-fed. A naughty, naughty little boy.
What did you do to this fish?
It's ginger.
It's really tasty.
Yeah. I'm a terrific cook.
This is like the best I've ever eaten. Really. But please, untie me. I'm more than happy to feed myself.
Nope. Daddy's not going anywhere until Mommy says that you've been a good little boy.
Please, listen to me for a second, okay? Just listen. I just met Betsy. She was at this cafe. I followed her to this speed date or diner date, a mosh and match. She brought us back here. She painted my picture. She drugged me, and I woke up to you. She was mad at me for some reason. I don't know what she told you, but I don't know what's happening here. Can you please just let me go, please?
Stop it. Okay? I don't enjoy this sort of thing.
And you think that I do?
You're not even playing correctly.
I'm not playing. I don't know who you and Betsy really are. I have no idea what's going on here. Can you please, please just let me go? Please? Mommy?
Don't say a word. Betsy, this is Amy. Please pick up. Okay, this is not going how I thought it would. Not that I'm not grateful. It's just... he seems really scared. Is he drugged or something? I don't know. Just, you've got to call me, so... call as soon as you get this message.
What do you have behind your back?
A surprise for you.
I don't like surprises.
Everybody likes surprises. They just don't like to admit it.
Did you talk to Betsy? Tell her she's made her point.
And that is?
I don't know, that I should treat women better, maybe?
Do you treat them badly?
No, I don't treat them at all. Women barely pay any attention to me. At least they never used to.
And they do now.
Well, just today, but it hasn't been good attention.
And what's so special about today?
Don't you know? It's the end of the world.
Okay, don't you think that's a little overdramatic?
Oh my God.
Whoops. Mommy is so scatterbrained, Daddy. Oops. I'm gonna be right back.
Happy birthday,
Mom.
Mr. President.
Make a wish.
Let me go?
No, you're not supposed to tell me what your wish is or else it won't come true. Well?
Well, what?
Well, blow out your candle.
It's not my birthday.
Jeez, you know, I'm really trying here. I mean, Betsy called and she said she had the perfect guy for me. That he'd be a little weird because he was into games, but that he would appreciate a romantic meal. And I said, fine, you know, I can deal with quirky. I asked why you were going to be asleep, and she said that you had just flown in from Reykjavik.
Iceland?
Yeah, and that you'd be tired, but that you still wanted to do this date because it was your birthday. And you were looking for the perfect person. And she thought that we would really hit it off, you know? I mean, could you just give me a chance here? I'm not very good at all this, but I could learn.
You know, your roommate is certifiable. I just met her. She mummified me and she chloroformed me.
You don't know her. She's a really good girl. She helps me out.
How's that? By kidnapping random strangers?
She just has a really wacky sense of humor, okay? But hey, you are single, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, this may seem strange, but I mean, we're both here already, and the food is prepared, and do you just, I mean, you want to do this date thing? It's your birthday.
Will you untie me?
How old are you today, Dan?
Excuse me?
How old are you?
I'm 35 today. Same as I was yesterday, because it's not my birthday.
Yeah. You're 35 and you're still single. Looks like you've had just about as much luck in the relationship department as I've had. Any previous marriages or girlfriends?
I've had dates. I've had girlfriends. Nothing's too long or serious.
Who's Shelley?
Okay, now I get it. How does Betsy fit into all this? Did she pay you? And are you guys friends with Shelley?
Ding, ding, ding. It's the magic word.
Shelley?
Yeah, it was written on the note. It's your safety word. But, you know, since you have no interest in playing the game, because apparently there never even was a game to begin with, I guess I'll just let you and Betsy work this out.
No, Amy! I need to find someone tonight.
Why?
Okay. It can't get any worse than this. Either I've suffered a mental breakdown and I need medical attention, or I had a vision that the world is ending tomorrow and I need to do something.
You don't look like you've suffered from a mental breakdown.
You don't know me.
Yes, but I know mental breakdowns. End of the world.
I know you don't believe me. I don't blame you. But as much as I want to get out of this tape because my arms are numb, it is even more important for me to get out of here to find my true love. Betsy didn't understand that, but I think you might.
Find your true love? I mean, is that what you need to do to prevent the world from ending?
I don't know if I can prevent the world from ending, but at least I'll have a chance to find her.
Okay.
Okay. So you'll let me go? I need to go.
Damn it.
You don't believe me.
I do believe you. You need to find someone. Well, so do I. I'm 35 and single, too. I think I can handle your baggage. So if you're looking for someone, what about me?
Wait, you're serious about this?
You seem like you're telling the truth.
Don't you wonder why the world is ending? Why I got this message?
Does it really matter? I'm here and you're here and... I'm willing to work on this if you are. Who knows, you know, maybe in its own weird way, this whole thing was destiny for us. So again, if you're looking for someone, I'm someone.
All right. Will you untie me?
Okay. Listen, I'm gonna trust you. If I untie you, you know, I want you to stay and date, eat, okay?
Yeah.
Scout's honor?
Yes. Yes, Scout's honor.
Okay.
How did you know I was a scout?
You have that look about you. I'm really sorry about that. I really had no idea.
Oh, I know.
Let's start over, okay? Hi, my name is Amy.
Hi, my name is Dan.
Hi, Dan. What do you do for a living?
I'm recently unemployed.
Oh, that sounds interesting.
It is. How about you? What do you do?
Little this, little that. Right now I'm temping for this company, just like doing random filing and stuff.
Oh, that's good. That's really good.
Yeah.
Do you believe in something?
Like what?
A philosophy in life. You see, I finally discovered my purpose. It's to find the right woman. I mean, she doesn't have to be perfect. She just has to be perfect for me.
That is so sweet. What's wrong?
Nothing. It's nothing. I mean, that rumbling in your stomach, it's not there.
Well, how do you know? Relationships take time, Dan. At least a couple of dates.
I don't have time. I wish I did, but I know this. Us, it's not right. Somehow I was scared straight into being a romantic. It's either love at first sight, or it isn't love at all.
Look, I might not be your ideal woman, okay? But look at yourself. I mean, you're not, like, a great catch. We're plain Janes. We're normal. We're like 90% of the world. We belong together.
Sorry. Please. I need to go. Will you let me go?
You're making a mistake.
Goodbye, Amy. You know, maybe I've lost it, but do yourself a favor. Don't go into work tomorrow. Take some time and do something for yourself instead.
You won't let me. Just go, okay? You're just standing there. I mean, it's not as if you're gonna stay, so. You're actually making things worse right now, which is pretty bad.
Sometimes I wish that I was sober. Sometimes I wish I was Cinderella. It's gonna rain before the night is over. I wish I had an umbrella.
You know what I have?
Enlighten me, Edison.
Women problems. I always wanted to come into a bar and say that.
Congratulations. I'm glad I could help you fulfill one of your life's dreams.
Yeah, dreams. Dreams are funny things.
Look, can we just talk about the ball game or something? Because I've had a rough day.
You've had a rough day? Let me tell you about my day. Let me tell you about my day. Did I say that twice? Either my day is gonna end like this. Or it's all kitty litter, and I ruined my life because I had some kind of freak out. Tell me, am I wasting my time?
You're wasting my time.
Here we go again.
Every day I sing the blues. My broken heart is rusted out with disuse. Well, without a word you left this town, I'll see you next time. To me, no, I can't believe, I know it must be easy to break my heart and leave me, but mama, she don't want no other fish in the sea. Well, when love was new, how I criticize, but now you're gone, I sit alone here and cry. Well, it seems my heart beats a lonely sound. I'll see you next time around. I'll see you next time.
I was sure she was the one. why. Just a fantasy, I guess.
Well, there's nothing wrong with fantasy. It beats reality.
Yeah, you're right. Mm-hmm. And if fantasy can become reality, well, isn't that worth pursuing?
I thought so.
Yeah, I think so, too. It is. Somehow I wonder if that's what this is all about. I know, you think I'm crazy.
You're my only fan, Dan. You have to be a little off.
Nah, you're amazing. Do you know that?
And you're really drunk.
You do that a lot. I used to do that.
What, tell people they're drunk?
No. Deflect any compliments. Try to convince people that I'm not talented or funny or whatever it is they're trying to tell me.
You're not. You're polite. Just like everyone else. Most people, anyway.
I'm not gonna deny the praise. I am polite.
I hate it. I hate politeness.
Screw you, then.
You don't sound very convincing, Dan.
What's wrong with being polite?
Well, you know. Miss Manners. Mannered. I don't know that word. It always sounded unreal to me. Like if a person is mannered, they're not letting you see the real them. It's like they're putting on a mask. That's what politeness is. It's not sincere. It's bullshit. And that's why I come here.
I thought you came here for me.
You're weird, Dan. You're just the type of person I would meet tonight. Capper to it all.
Thanks.
Started coming here a month ago. When things started getting really bad. I have tried so hard for so long.
With your singing, your voice is incredible. You should have a huge following. I really think that you have talent.
From that story you just told me, Dan, you seem like the type of guy that would believe in anything. But, well, it's not the singing, but, well, it is singing. It's everything. I've tried to be good, to be happy, to work hard, to succeed, to fall in. And everybody says the right thing. With their plastic smiles and their fake applause. You think I can't tell? You think I'm so fucking desperate for adulation that I'll just accept anything people give me? I need to know I moved someone. That I touched them. I thought I had. Really fell for it. Look where it got me.
Everything worth having is worth fighting for. I mean, if life was easy, it wouldn't be worth it.
What kind of perverted logic is that? That anything that's worth having has to be hard and painful? Night after night, I sing with everything that I am and everything that I have. And I'm greeted with half-hearted applause from a half-empty audience. Do you know what that tells me, Dan? Do you know what that politeness does to me? It tells me that I'm nothing. Kills me. It's been killing me for a long time.
Well, this isn't the best venue. Maybe the marina.
I'm talking about the marina. That's what kills me. It's dealing with people like that. Singing in places like that. They tell you one thing, they lead you on, they make you promises. That's just because that's what you want to hear and they don't want to lead you on. It's like a room full of ghosts. This place is the truth. When I needed to sing and I couldn't stand to look at their faces, I came here. stumbled across it one night after we started fighting. It called to me in its pathetic way. There was an empty stage, an empty bar. It was perfect for me. I started coming here after shows. Then I couldn't stand to go home anymore. Then I came here instead of shows. Then I couldn't stop. I just kept coming back and singing. I had to let it all out. I just couldn't stand it anymore.
I don't understand, Christy. I thought this was a gig. I mean, it was odd coming in here, like kind of some kind of rush. But I thought it was this big secret that I had, that I had found you. They don't pay you?
This place? Maybe you aren't so polite.
And that's a good thing, right?
Yeah, to me it is. And why didn't you ask her before?
Who? Carrie? The girl at the flower shop?
Yeah, you don't seem like you're scared of women.
You got me on a good day.
What day is it? Got me on a good day, too. No more bad days for me.
That's right. That's a good attitude.
To the end of the world?
Why the hell not? Sounds like both our worlds need ending. Start of a new day. Beginning of a new era.
Blah, blah, blah. Drink up, Nostradamus.
I think I should stop.
That's when you order another bottle.
I was scared.
You should have thought of that before you came into this bar.
No, I didn't ask her because I was scared.
Of being rejected?
Yes, to be honest. I was scared of everything. But I'm not anymore.
Oh, too bad.
No. I can't remember a day where I've done more. It's a good thing.
Being scared is being safe. Animals are scared. It's part of their survival instinct. It's the dumb bunny that goes gallivanting into the field that gets ripped to shreds by the badger.
The badger?
Yeah, badgers eat bunnies, don't they? I wish I'd been more scared in my life. I wouldn't have wasted my life singing.
Yeah, but surely you got some joy out of it.
Excuse me. Gotta use the little girl's room.
Here you go.
I think we've had enough.
Maybe you have, but she's the one who's paying.
She's stunning, isn't she?
Yeah, she's easy on the eyes.
Yeah, I know what you mean. But I was talking about her singing. She said she's been coming here for 2 months.
I know. That chick gets old.
What? I thought it'd be a treat for you.
What'd I just say?
Come on. You're telling me that she comes here every day and you don't think that she's good?
Honestly, I wouldn't know.
She's good. She's real good.
What you doing here, then?
Oh, good. I like tequila.
Christy, I think we should call it a night.
Oh. Fine. It was nice talking to you.
It was nice talking to you, too. I would like to talk to you some more. Only not at this place. It's kind of a downer.
Sure is. But I'm glad I could cheer you up enough so that you can move on. Me?
I belong here.
Oh, come on. You're drunk. Me too, I'm drunk. I mean, I don't see anything wrong with drinking our problems away, but maybe we could work on our problems together. You know, in a better way.
Dan, are you hitting on me?
Yes.
God, you're dense.
No, I'm just not scared anymore. I mean, go ahead, rip me to shreds, cut me down. If it makes you feel better, I'm here for you.
No, I'm not gonna do that. Thanks, though. Thanks for being here with me. Maybe I'm being selfish, but I want you to stay.
Really? Even after I hit on you, you want me to stay? Does that mean?
It means I want you to stay and talk to me. Nothing more.
Okay. But I'm not drinking anymore.
Oh, I ordered this for me. Me alone. I need it.
Christy, why are you doing this to yourself?
I'm not doing this to myself. This was done to me, don't you understand?
Did somebody hurt you?
No. Don't do it, Dan. Don't put yourself out there. Look, I can see you're going through a change, and everyone else in the world is gonna think it's a good thing. But it's not. It's not a good thing. You were right. People just hurt you. You can love someone and it can be amazing. You won't need anything else. I saw you walk in here and I was happy for you because you were just another loser drinking in the middle of the day. You were the lucky one. Trudging through life, not expecting much.
Christy, that life is over. I'm not going back there. Even if you tell me all the terrible things that's happened to you, I want that. Everything led us here, right here. I mean, how often do two people connect like this? Like you and I are connecting right now.
It happens all the time, sweetie. And just like a little kid. Dan, I gotta tell you something.
Okay. But when you're done telling me what you want to tell me, I want you to listen to me.
Maybe you were supposed to find me. Maybe you did see God.
That doesn't matter anymore.
But if it does, if there's something out there, tell it that I'm sorry.
What do you have to be sorry for?
Thanks for being here with me, but I think you should go now. It's not fair to you, and I don't want you to blame yourself in any way.
Christy, what are you talking about? What did you do?
I told you I needed that tequila.
Oh, shit. Christy, don't do this to me. Don't do this to me.
I'm tired of giving everything that I have. Just isn't good enough for her.
Her? Come on, do you want to dance? Call 911, get an ambulance.
No.
Come on, Christy, stay with me.
What's it matter? World's gonna end.
Not like this. Not like this. It's not gonna end like this.
Why'd she leave me?
I'll find her for you. Christy, I'll find her for you.
Kathy,
please stay with
you
me.
You do that for me.
Yes, I promise.
Dan.
No, not now.
She's not the one for you.
I know.
time.
I don't care. Just let me help her.
She's got her destiny. You've got yours.
What happens to her if she dies?
That's not for you to know.
She's not going to die.
What if it's not up to you?
Look, I give up whatever you're offering. I don't need it. Not now. This is more important.
More important than her soulmate?
Right now, I need to help Christy.
It won't matter by tomorrow.
It will to me. No, please. I didn't ask for this.
Please, Christy, stay with me. Come on.
EMS, we got a call. All right, let's get her out of here.
Hi, Mom. I'm sorry to call you so early. No, everything's fine. I just wanted to call and hear your voice. Yeah, and to tell you that I love you. No, I promise, everything's okay. Yeah, go back to bed. Hi, Shelly. This is Dan. I know you probably hate me, but I needed to call and apologize. I didn't mean to treat you that way, and I was scared. You know, I didn't mean to demean you or your job or anything. Look, I know Mr. Wright's gonna come your way, and I just didn't want to get in the way of that guy. Listen, last night was a little weird, and I just wanted to see if we could start over, you know, maybe try again, only a little less pressure, but maybe you could cook me dinner at my place. Oh, and if you talk to Betsy, let her know that I don't care what she did, but if she ever puts you in that position again, I'm gonna be ready. Okay? You tell her that. Hi, Christy, it's Dan. I don't know how much you're gonna remember about last night, but I just wanted to call and see how you were doing. Kathy called your family. And I think you're in good hands. The doctor said you're gonna be okay, too. Do me a favor, give me a call when you get out, okay? I'd like to talk to you in person to thank you for last night. Anyways, just call me.
Hey, hi. Can you?
Yeah.
Thanks. I'm lucky to find you here. I just know I'm gonna drop something.
Oh, it's no problem. I can help.
Thanks. Perfect timing. Guess we made it, huh? You get to see the whole thing.
What? You mean
the sunrise. Just you wait. It's gonna be beautiful.
When's the last time you saw a sunrise?
Yesterday, but I haven't seen it from this spot in quite a while. I used to come here all the time.
Yeah?
I just wanted to leave it behind me. Then it hit me. Some of the happiest memories I have started right here. And I've stayed away for so long.
What is it that brought you back?
I just realized that what was keeping me away was just small compared to everything I love about it.
Bad experience?
Sad experience. But really just experience. Life. Used to hurt just thinking about this place. I wish things could have turned out differently, but what if...
What if it's not up to you?
Exactly.
I can't claim that. I actually learned that from a friend.
Is that who you were talking to on the phone up there? You were on it for quite a while.
Were you there the whole time?
I gotta confess, it was really hard not to eavesdrop on your conversation. It sounded like you have a lot on your mind.
I do. Oh, I did have a lot on my mind. I'm trying to let all that go. It's what I learned, or relearned. I already knew all that stuff, just somehow I...
Been denying it for your whole life?
I'm sorry. Being rude. Hi, my name's Dan.
Abby. Nice to meet you, Dan.
Nice to meet you, Abby.
So, what brought you here?
Just wanted to be by the water.
I'm glad you did. I forgot how bulky fishing gear can be.
Hey, would you be interested in... would you like to... Would you...
I'd like to have breakfast. How about pancakes?
I love pancakes. And waffles. And French toast.
Well, I know a great place. It opens at 10.
That's a few hours away.
Do you think we'll make it until then?
Abby, did you?
Shh. We'll miss it.
I should have came here sooner.
We're here now. That's all that matters.
I'm sorry.
Don't be. If we're wrong, we'll have something to talk about over breakfast.
And if we're not?
Then we better make our first kiss count.
Here knows how to mess through a nation of time.
night I had myself a dream. I saw you and those lovely things you used to do. When I woke up, I just could not believe what a sweet, sweet woman you were to me. What a sweet, sweet woman you were to me. Like you've been calling on me at all, and I haven't been reminded of you that I can't recall. But there you were in my arms last Monday night, and if I weren't so lonely, it would be all right. Last night I had myself a dream. I saw you and those lovely things you used to do. When I woke up, I just could not believe what a sweet, sweet woman you were to me. What a sweet, sweet woman you were to me. Last night I had myself a dream. It starred you and those lovely things you used to do. When I woke up, I just could not believe what a sweet, sweet woman you were to me. What a sweet, sweet woman you were to me.